Welcome to Colourful Mermaids, Episode 3. This episode is about showing you around the Skylight House, which is where they're living at the moment. And here's Belinda. I found her staring dreamily into space. That's the view she was looking at through the window behind her there. And she's going to demonstrate the witch's broom riding arena. First of all, she's just going to fly around a bit, and then she's going to do a stunt ride for us. This is really about showing you the house rather than the witch doing the acrobats. This arena takes up 3 levels, and it's immediately above the garden that is on the ground level. This is the garden that has the wishing well and the chicken coop in it. So this will take up levels 2, 3 and 4 of the above ground part of the Skylight House. Now she's doing some stunts by the look of it. Just taking you up a few levels just to see how high up this is actually meant to be. So there's plenty of room there for the witches to fly around. It's lucky we had a mermaid who's also a witch to demonstrate it, and fortunately that I found her standing quite close to the arena when I opened the game. Now, on the same level, level 2 above ground, is a gym, and I found Estelle training Simon, and I also found Harry working out there as well. So we've got a little bit of video of Harry working on the exercise machines in the gym. That's a part of the Skylight House. I've often wondered how mermaids got such muscly upper bodies, because they don't use their arms when they're swimming. But I can see now that they work out hard in the gym. This is the Skylight House from the outside, showing you the whole building. And here it is from the other side, showing you the roof areas. Now meet the ex-butler, Beau Stallings. I saw him around the house occasionally, but he was mostly totally useless. So now he's a part of the household, the human part of the household. He does things that I don't want mermaids to do because they might dry out too fast. Fortunately, I had recently moved the butler into the household when I decided to increase the size of the household to move them to Cake Island. And this video was all shot after the preparations were completed to go to Cake Island. And I was able to show you the roof area being used. I would never have taken a mermaid up to sit at a fire pit on top of a hot roof like this. But he wasn't a very good cook, was he? He managed to burn his marshmallows. And then he ate them. The look on his face. And then I decided to show you the climatron in action. He just needs to walk down those steps to get to the climatron. I'll get him to change the weather to foggy, but I don't want it to be foggy, so he'll turn it back to sunny again straight away. I've only used this thing a couple of times, ever, and it does work. At least it's worked in my game the couple of times I've used it. I should have it in the game all the time, because all that rain I get in Hidden Springs and places like that. Could be something I might think about adding to the McFluff story while they're in Hidden Springs. Now he's changing it back to sunny. Now there's a little area there on the roof where there's a barbecue, and this area is just inside, a little kitchen area that's just inside from the bar. You can see through those slit windows the barbecue area outside. I had asked him to barbecue something, but he decided that there was already in the fridge, so he'd just go and eat it out of the fridge. But I am determined that he's going to use that barbecue, so we'll keep going until he does. he needs to go, when he's finished using the climatron, he needs to go down some internal steps near the witch's broom riding arena and come in to this room and through this door to get out here. So the door there is behind. That door will lead to him eventually to the area where the witch's broom riding arena is. You can get a bit of a view of the structure of the house with the roof off. This area on the right, and now it's the back, that's the butler's quarters. Hello, Harry's turned up. Don't know what he doesn't like about that cabinet, but he's got himself a drink out of the bar. Now, with butler is finally going to cook some sausages on the very smoky barbecue. It does actually have flame. I was trying to get a picture of the flame, but I couldn't get up close enough, quick enough. Once the sausages were on, you couldn't really see the flame so well. They're very small, well-controlled, which is fortunate because he burnt these marshmallows up on the fire pit. I suppose he wasn't really hungry by this time because he ate the marshmallows and then he ate some that food out of the fridge. So no wonder he just put them down on the table and walked off. I did get him to call the household to a meal, but I don't think anyone's bothered to show up, so I'll probably have to throw them out shortly. Now he's gone back in through that door. We might have a look at the butler's quarters while we're here. This door on the right, that leads through to the where the witch's arena is. Now the butler's quarters, that's a fence, and I think it came with late night, and there's a gate there as well which is locked, so the household members can't get in there. It's a bit hard to get pictures of it, and I didn't have it well lit because it is not set up for filming this house. The butler's got a little seating area, it's got a lounge chair and a TV, and then down that hallway there's a bathroom and a bedroom for him. There's his bed. Then we'll have a look from the up above. You can see that's the area with the little kitchen on the top left. Down below is where he walks into his little office area. Then there's to the right, there's his seating area, his bathroom and his bed. And the top there is the barbecue. Now I thought, you've seen enough of the house for now, so let's see the mermaids going for a swim. And this will take us through to the end of the video. And I'll show you more of the house next video. I like how they're all using the same spot, the exact same spot. At this, the swimming part of it was actually recorded before I recorded the house part of it. So at this point, the butler is still a butler. And Salty and Maya Ocean are still mermaids out in the ocean. They're not part of the household. So you've just sort of gone back in time by a few sim hours, really. But there's some nice video here, so I thought I would, didn't want to just throw it out. In this one, I've started to get more comfortable with the mermaids, and they are actually doing a bit of fishing and catching of sea life while they're in the dive lot. And they meet Salty for the first time, and you see Salty get his scales. When I reopened this game this morning, I was thinking I'd have to abandon it because I've added the townie mermaids to the household and I haven't kept old saves. And I thought, if I was going to keep doing videos, we'll need those mermaids wild so they can show the mermaids island, secret island. But I've now realised that I've only added Salty and Maya Ocean to the household at this point. So there's still two mermaids out there who could show them mermaid secret island. So I'll keep the series going in Isla Paradiso for a bit longer. I'm also recording video of them in Cake Island, but I don't know when I'll show you that. It's got a lot more sims in it, and I'm building dive lots there now as well. And the house that I'm showing you from now on may not be actually identical with all the furniture placed in the right spots. I'm trying to get it back to how it was, but I packed up a lot of stuff and took it to Cake Island. And now I'm trying to put it back where it was to be able to show you around the house. But it's all the same furniture, it's just that I may not have got it placed exactly at the right angles and that sort of thing. I'm not sure what dive light this is. It's about time they went down though, I think. I don't know, are they going to wait for everybody to turn up? I see that Suki's still got her old tail as well. I've changed her tail colour since this video was shot. And I suppose the other two have still got their sunglasses on. They've gone now. I'll show you eventually me getting rid of them. It's just that that hasn't happened. I've got so much video recorded I can't show you it all at once. It'd take hours. You can see their house in the background. That's the roof, the skylight house with the glass roof back in the distance. Here we go, we're down in the dive lot. They'll just hang around there and swim around for a little bit. That's George and Simon. Simon was the new one that I made specially, and so was Suki, and all the rest are old Sims that I've converted to be mermaids, including a genie, a witch, and a fairy. There is Salty, the first time we've seen Salty with this game. So I'll change his scales, so he's got scales. Shark there too. Now he's got his scales now, you can see them. I didn't actually show you all the menu options. I've shown you that enough times, so he must be getting a bit boring by now. But he'll have his tail next time we see him. He's just got his leg scales at this point. So we've got Sims harvesting kelp and chasing underwater sea life. Socialising. I like how they dive down to catch something. Just like that. He's the genie, I can tell by his little top knot. I didn't know he had a little knot on his top of his head like that. I thought it was just a wave of hair wisping off in the distance, but it looks like it's a little bun or something. She's gone down to catch something. Oh, we're going down to the treasure chest. I have no idea what treasure she's going to get. Maybe she's not going to do it. Sometimes they don't, they just won't. I think that might be the one that they refused to open. I tried a few goes at it and they didn't touch it. No idea why. They've got all got diving level 10, so it can't be that their diving level's not high enough. Maybe their diving level's too high. I don't know. I don't think that's possible, though. It's a very inviting-looking treasure chest. I'd like it to see it opened. She's just just going to stay there and stare at it through her sunglasses. It's better without the user interface in the way all the time. Maybe she'll harvest some kelp. That's not mermaid kelp, but they can still eat it. I often wonder what the little black goldfish is doing down in the salty water. Nice swordfish. It's funny how the hair doesn't float when they're swimming around. You'd see big halos of hair around them. But no, it's all down, nicely brushed down. Held in place. Maybe they've just used a lot of hairspray or something. Waterproof hairspray. One octopus just got caught. I'm pleased I didn't add the final two mermaids to the household yet. Before I saved it, I must have just added them in and then put them straight into my library, because they're all there together in Cake Island. That's Belinda the Witch, who was doing the broom riding earlier when we first started this video. Not many mermaids around. There's still a couple swimming down here. I think they might be heading off home. Sometimes they get broken up. Some go home, get sick of it, go back home, or just swim around on the surface for a while. And others like to stay down for a lot longer. I've discovered they need to be in salt water. Just being in the swimming pool isn't enough for them. So that's why I've built them dive lots at Cake Island. I've not shown you any Cake Island video yet, so you haven't missed it, it's just not been shown yet, but I've only got little bits of it recorded. I have been posting lots of pictures of them in Cake Island on the forums though, if you get a chance to look at the Sims 3 forums for about the time that this video was being made. Here they are, they've come to the surface. So this must be getting close to the end of the video. It's getting quite long. I'll try to keep this under 15 minutes. It's already gone to just past 18 minutes. So I won't add any more video to this. We'll just say goodbye to them. And I'll thank you for watching. Hope you've enjoyed it. And I'll see you next video, where we'll see more of the house and more of them swimming around. Bye-bye for now, and happy swimming.